So good morning everyone. Today I am going to discuss the molecular orbital theory, the conditions. As I discussed in the last video lecture, condition for the combination of atomic orbitals. So third conditions, the combining atomic orbitals should have the same symmetry. The combining atomic orbitals should have the same symmetry. So in the first one, the combining atomic orbitals should have almost same energy and extent of overlap should be large. Third one is combining atomic orbital should have the same symmetry above the molecular axis or along the internuclear axis. So combining atomic orbitals should have the same symmetry above the molecular axis. For example, 2px orbital of one atom can combine with 2px orbital of other atom, but not with the 2pz orbitals, which means if the atomic orbitals have same or nearly the same energy, will not combine. If they do not have the same symmetry, it must be noted that z axis is taken as the internuclear axis according to the modern convention. So combining atomic orbitals should have the same symmetry about the internuclear axis. For example, 2px orbital of one atom can combine with 2px orbital of other atom, but not with the 2pz orbitals, which means if the atomic orbitals have same or nearly the same energy, will not combine. If they do not have the same symmetry, so they should have the same, suppose two atomic orbitals have same energy, okay, but this must possess the same symmetry, otherwise the combination of atomic orbital will not be possible. So it must be noted that z axis taken as the internuclear axis according to the modern convention. So that is the third conditions, combination of atomic orbitals. So now let us see the graphical representations. This is the 1s, this is the 1s. So 1s or atomic orbital overlap with another 1s atomic orbitals. Through subtraction we get what? We get sigma star 1s. Sigma star 1s means antibonding sigma molecular orbital. So this is the antibonding molecular orbital. That's why it represents sigma star or asterisk. Sigma asterisk means antibonding, only sigma means bonding MO. When 1s atomic orbital overlap with another 1s orbitals through additions, then we get a bonding molecular orbital. This is the bonding sigma molecular orbital, okay, sigma 1s, which is denoted as sigma 1s. So during the electronic MO electronic configuration, one can write KK instead of sigma 1s2 and sigma star 1s2 KSL, okay. So that is the with respect to A, and with respect to B, if 2pz overlap with another 2pz through subtraction, we get antibonding sigma molecular orbital. If 2pz overlap with another 2pz through additions, then we get sigma 2pz, that is bonding molecular orbitals. So if 1s overlap with another 1s through subtraction, we get antibonding. Keep in mind, if 1s overlap with another 1s through additions, then we get sigma 1s, that is bonding MO. If 2pz, as I told you, p orbital has 3 sub orbitals or 3 degenerate orbitals, px, py, pz. Why? Due to the 3 value of magnetic quantum number, 0, plus 1, minus 1. Okay, so then you get antibonding MO, if 2pz orbital overlap with another 2pz atomic orbitals, then you get through additions bonding molecular orbital. So figure says counters and energy of bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals formed through combination of 1s atomic orbital and 2pz atomic orbital. Now, types of molecular orbital. As you know, atomic orbitals are designated as SPDF of the molecular orbital of diatomic molecules are named as sigma and pi, sigma bond and pi bond. Okay. So what is sigma molecular orbital? The molecular orbitals which are cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis are called sigma molecular orbital. Again, the molecular orbitals which are cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis, cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis are called sigma molecular orbital. So we know types of molecular orbital. We have two types of molecular orbitals. One is sigma molecular orbitals, another is pi molecular orbitals. So sigma molecular orbitals which are formed cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis are called sigma molecular orbital. Okay, so this is the types of molecular orbital and the third conditions at combining atomic orbitals should have same symmetry. So next, this is the graphical representation. As I told you, in case of 1s overlap with another 1s through addition or subtraction, if addition then get bonding, if subtraction then you get antibonding. Okay. For example, molecular orbitals formed by addition of 1s orbital is designated as a sigma 1s, and the molecular orbital formed by the subtraction of 1s orbital is designated as a sigma star 1s, sigma star 1s. Similarly, combination of 2s orbital result in the formation of two sigma molecular orbitals, that is sigma 2s and sigma star 2s. Star means antibonding and only sigma means bonding among. Okay. So for example, molecular orbital formed by the addition of 1s orbital is designated as sigma 1s, and the molecular orbital formed by the subtraction of 1s orbital is designated as sigma star 1s. Similarly, the combination of 2s orbital results. Combination of 2s orbitals results in the formation of two sigma molecular orbitals designated as sigma 2s and sigma star 2s. Okay. So here 2px overlap with 2px atomic orbital of father. Through subtraction we get bonding pi, okay, bonding pi molecular orbitals and bonding antibonding and bonding pi molecular orbitals. Why? Now because, so how pi molecular orbital are formed? Lateral overlap. So molecular orbital actually sigma bond is formed head on overlap, and pi bond is formed lateral overlap or sidewise. Sidewise overlap or lateral overlap of p orbital leads to the formation of pi molecular orbitals. So molecular orbitals which are formed by lateral overlap pi orbitals are called pi molecular orbitals. So this one, 2px overlap with 2px, through subtraction we get antibonding molecular orbital. pi star to px, and if 2px overlap with another 2px atomic orbital through addition, then we get only pi 2px, that is bonding MO. So this is the counters and energy of bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals formed through combination of 2px atomic orbital. So combination of 2px atomic orbitals. So these molecular orbitals are not cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis. These molecular orbitals are not cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis because of the presence of positive lobes above and negative lobes below the molecular plane. For example, the additions and subtraction overlap or 2px orbitals result in the formation of 2px and 2px star molecular orbitals. And addition subtraction overlap of 2py orbital result in the 2py and star 2py molecular orbitals respectively. Why? Because when you get bonding MO, we get simple pi or simple sigma. When you get antibonding, you get star. So these molecular orbitals are not cylindrically symmetrical around the internuclear axis or bond axis because of the presence of positive lobes above and negative lobes below the molecular plane. But for example, the additions and subtraction overlap of 2px orbitals result in the formation of 2px and 2p star x molecular orbitals, and addition and subtraction overlap of 2py orbitals result in the formation of 2py and star 2py molecular orbital respectively. So this is the pi molecular orbital and this is the graphical representations of pi molecular orbital. Okay, next is electronic configuration of molecular orbital. So the distribution of electrons among the various molecular orbital, distribution of electrons among the various molecular orbitals is called electronic configuration of the molecule. Distribution of energy among the various molecular orbital called electronic configuration of the molecule. From the electronic configuration of the molecule, it is possible to get important information about the nomenclature about the molecule as discussed below. The distribution of electron among the various molecular orbital is called electronic configuration of this molecule. From the electronic configuration of the molecule, it is possible to get important information about the molecule as discussed below. The molecule is stable. When the molecule is said to be stable? When NB is greater than NA. What is NB? Number of bonding electron, and NA number of antibonding electron. After writing MO electronic configurations, you get number of bonding electron and number of antibonding electron. So molecule is stable if NB is greater than NA. If NB is greater than NA, then molecule is stable. The molecule is unstable if NB is less than NA. If NB is less than NA, then molecule is unstable. molecule is unstable if NB is equal to NA, where NB is number of bonding electron, NA is number of antibonding electron. So three cases: if NB greater than NA, then the molecule is stable. If molecule is unstable, that is NB is less than NA, a molecule is unstable, NB is equal to the NA, that is NBL equals to NGO, NBA, where NBA is the number of bonding electron, NA is number of antibonding electron. Bond order, what is the bond order? Next, very important, bond order. Bond order can be defined. Bond order can be defined as the half of the difference between the number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital and number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbitals follows. You see, bond order, number of electrons in bonding MOs minus number of electrons in antibonding MOs, that is half of NBA minus NEF. So half of minus NBA minus NA, so that is the bond order. So number of electron in bonding MOs minus number of electron in antibonding MOs. Okay, the bond order conveys the following important information. If the value of bond order is positive, that is NB greater than NA, it indicates a stable molecules. And if the value of bond order is negative or zero, it means that the molecule is unstable and is not formed. If the value of bond order is positive, that is NB greater than NA, it indicates a stable molecule. And if the value of bond order is negative or zero, it means that molecule is unstable and is not formed. Now, dissociation energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the bond energy of the molecule. So which molecule are according to bond order, so which molecule has least dissociation energy? So dissociation energy of molecule is directly proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond orders, greater is the bond dissociation energy. So bond dissociation energy means higher the bond order, higher will be the bond dissociation energy. That means if the molecule consists of higher bond order, then what will happen? It will demand more energy. So dissociation energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the bond order of the molecule. So dissociation energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond order, greater is the bond dissociation energy. So higher the bond dissociation energy means shorter wavelength. Okay, so dissociation energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond order, greater is the bond dissociation energy. Bond length of the molecule is inversely proportional. Bond length of the molecule is inversely proportional to the bond order of the molecules. Bond length, higher the bond length, lesser will be bond order, or higher the bond order, lesser will be its bond length. So bond length of a molecule is inversely proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond order, shorter will be the bond strength. So greater the bond order, shorter will be the bond strength. Next point, knowing the bond order The number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecule can be predicted by bond order of molecule. Knowing the bond order, the number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecule can be predicted. Bond order of the molecule is equal to the number of equivalent bond between the atoms in the molecule. So bond order of atomic bond order of molecule is equal to the number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecule. So integral bond order values 1 2 3 correspond to single bond, double bond, triple bond. So if bond order, if you found bond order 1 2 3, then you can say single bond, double bond, triple bond. Okay, so next is bond length. The bond order between the two atoms in molecule may be taken as the approximate measure of the bond length. Bond length decreases as bond order increases. So again, I just recap, the molecule is stable when the molecule will be called stable. Now when NB is greater than NA, when molecule is unstable, when NB is less than NA, and molecule is unstable if NB is equal to NA, then NA is number of bonding electron, NB is the number of antibonding electron. So bond order can be defined as the half of the difference between the number of electrons of bonding molecular orbital and the number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbital. So bond order equals to number of electrons in bonding MOs minus number of electrons in antibonding MOs, or half of NB minus NA. Okay. Now bond order conveys the following important information. If the values of bond order is positive, NB greater than NA, it indicates a stable molecule. And if the value of bond order is negative or zero, that is NB less than NA or NB equals to NA, it seems that the molecule is unstable. If NB A minus NA, NB minus NA indicates indicates a stable molecule, and if the value of bond order is negative or zero, it means that molecule is unstable and is not formed. So diffusion energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond order, greater will be the dissociation energy. So higher the bond order, higher will be the bond dissociation energy. So higher means bond length is shorter, higher it demands higher energy to dissociate or break this bond. Bond length of the molecule is inversely proportional to the bond order of the molecule. In other words, greater the bond order, shorter will be the bond length. So greater the bond order, shorter will be the bond length. Okay. Knowing the bond order, the number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecules can be predicted. Knowing the bond order, number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecule can be predicted. Bond order of maximum, bond order of molecule is equal to the number of covalent bond between the atoms in the same bond length. Okay. So in the molecule, knowing the bond order, the number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecules can be predicted. Bond order of the molecule is equal to the number of covalent bonds between the atoms in the molecule. Integral bond order values 1, 2, 3 correspond to single, double, triple bond respectively. If bond order is found 1, then it is what? So it's named will be सिंगल बॉन्ड, if it is two, then it is called double bond. If it is called three, then it is called triple bond. So bond length, bond order between two atoms in molecule may be taken as the approximate measure of the bond length. So bond order between two atoms in the molecule may be taken as approximate measure of the bond length. So bond length decreases as bond order increases. Keep in mind, bond length decreases as bond order increases. Next move of nature of the bond. Integral bond order values 1, 2, 3 correspond to single, double bond, triple bonds respectively. Magnetic nature of behavior. Magnetic behavior of molecule can also be predicted from the electronic configuration. If all the electrons in molecules are paired, the substance is diamagnetic, repelled by magnetic field. And in case there are unpaired electrons in a molecule, the substance is paramagnetic, and it may be noted that if the bond order is fractional, then molecule will definitely paramagnetic, attracted by magnetic field. As per example, oxygen molecule is present, oxygen molecule is paramagnetic and nitrogen is diamagnetic. Again I repeat, the magnetic behavior of molecule can also be predicted from the electronic configuration. If all the electrons in a molecule are paired, the substance is diamagnetic, repelled by magnetic field. And in case there are unpaired electrons in a molecule, the substance is paired, substance is paramagnetic. And we noted that the bond order is fractional, the molecule will definitely paramagnetic, attracted by the magnetic field. O2 molecule is paramagnetic and N2 is diamagnetic. Let us discuss the bonding of some homonuclear diatomic molecule. So in the previous slide we have discussed the different points on which the bond order depends. Next, we know the bond length, what is the bond length in a molecule. Next is the nature of bond. If bond order is found 1, 2, 3, then it is single bond, double bond, triple bond. Now magnetic behavior. So magnetic behavior of the molecule can also be predicted from the electronic configuration. If all the electrons in a molecule are paired, the substance is diamagnetic, repelled by magnetic field. And in case there are unpaired electron in molecule, the substance is paramagnetic. It may be noted that if the bond order is fractional, the molecule will definitely be paramagnetic. As for example, O2 molecule is paramagnetic, N2 is diamagnetic. Let us discuss the bonding of some homonuclear diatomic species. Hydrogen molecule. It is formed by the combination of two hydrogen atoms. So it is formed by the combination of two hydrogen atoms. Each hydrogen atom has one electron in 1s orbital. Therefore, in all there are two electron hydrogen atoms which are present in sigma 1s molecular orbital. So electronic configuration of hydrogen molecules is sigma 1s2, okay, or 1s square. The molecular orbital diagram of H2 molecule is shown in the right hand side. So bond order should be 1, because number of bonding electron 2, number of antibonding 0. So that's why it is called 2 by 2, that is 1. So in case of H2, so that's why in between H2 there is a single bond. So here antibonding, here bonding, this is the atomic orbital, this is the atomic orbital. So energy of the this bonding MO always lesser than the atomic orbital of the ligand, and also less than the molecular orbital of H2. So this is the hydrogen molecule H2. So it is formed by the combination of two atomic hydrogen. Each hydrogen atom has one electron in 1s orbital. Therefore, in all there are two electrons in hydrogen molecule which are present in sigma 1s molecular orbital. So electronic configuration of the hydrogen molecule is sigma 1s square. The molecular orbital diagram 1s2, molecular orbital diagram of H2, molecular orbital diagram of H2 molecule is shown in the right hand side, Bernoulli NB minus NM. Okay, this is the molecular orbital diagram. So this means that the two hydrogen atoms, this means that two hydrogen atoms are bonded together. This means that the two hydrogen atoms are bonded together by a single covalent bond. The bond dissociation energy of hydrogen molecule has been found. The bond dissociation energy of hydrogen molecule has been found to be 438 kilojoule. It should be kilojoule per mole. Kilojoule per, it should be kilojoule per mole. Okay, so by mistake it has been written as a actually it should be mole inverse, and the bond length equal to 74 picometer. Since no unpaired electron is present in hydrogen molecule, therefore it is diamagnetic. So all two electrons are paired up in condition, so that is it is a diamagnetic. So magnetic behavior properties we should mention. Okay, if you get the number of unpaired electrons, then you can find out the mu value, root over n into n plus 2. Okay, so now hydrogen molecule cation H2 plus, this is found by the combination of hydrogen atom containing one electron and hydrogen ion having no electron. Therefore this molecule ion has only one electron, H2 plus. This electron is present in the lowest or lowermost MOS sigma 1s. So electronic configuration of H2 plus sigma 1s whole to the power 1, as it releases one electrons. So molecular orbital diagram of H2 plus is shown in the next slide. Again, so in case of H2 plus, H2, H2 plus, H2 bond order 1, okay. In case of H2, it is also half of bonding minus anti bonding, so that it is also, that is bonding 2, it is actually 1, because it is possesses plus sign, that means it loses one electrons. So that's why in case of H2 plus cations, the MO electronic configuration will be sigma 1s square. Okay, that means it possesses one electron. So bond order will be half of NB minus NA, that is 1 by 2. Okay, so molecular orbital like H2 plus will be discussed in the next slide. So as I told you, the important points regarding the bond order, nature of bond, I have discussed. Magnetic behavior, whether paramagnetic or diamagnetic. If it contains pair electrons, then it is called diamagnetic. If it contains in MOS unpaired electron, then it is called paramagnetic. Okay, and also the example, if you take the example of homonuclear molecules hydrogen, so it is formed by the combination of two hydrogen atoms. Each hydrogen atom has one electron in 1s orbital. Therefore, in all, there are two electrons in hydrogen molecules which are present in the sigma 1s molecular orbital. So electronic configuration will be sigma 1s square in case of H2. If it is considered H2 plus, that means one electron has been removed because it loses one electron. So that is sigma 1s 1. So half of bonding electron minus half of antibonding electron. So in this way we get the bond order of H2, that is 1, okay, and also find out the bond order of H2 plus. So in case of H2, the bond two hydrogen atoms are bonded together by single covalent bond, because here bond order is 1, so each hydrogen is attached with another hydrogen atom through single bond. So I hope you are enjoying this video. Thanks for watching this video.